Welcome to our short update for TOMTEC ARENA 230. In ImageCom, the secondary study review has changed. If you go now on the patient history, you see there's the active study and the old study, and both have this green eye. And if you click on the green eye, you can load the old study also in the DICOM viewer area, so here in the review area. And the blue frame shows that you've loaded an old study, and you can scroll back and forth through the complete study and watch all the images without drag and drop them from the thumbnail bar. And of course, you can also load the active study completely and have the old study only in the thumbnail bar. You see now the blue background, and then you can drag and drop also the images in the viewing area, like before in the older versions. If we go now back to the measurements, then you see we have here a new filter option, so you can filter now the menu, so the measurements menu, for all the measurements you want to have. So here we have the factory settings, and also we filtered for the auto measurements. Now you see our measurements menu has only the auto measurements. For the exam types, we have now adult echo and also pediatric echo, where you can select different measurement packages. So here you see the pediatric echo, and of course you can also set different measurements menus like here for the auto measurements. In the thumbnail bar, you can also filter now for different objects. So at the moment you can see we selected all 2D images and also 3D images, and we can filter for example just for 3D, and then you see just the 3D image. And you can also filter for bookmarks. Another change in TOMTEC ARENA 230 is the measurements overlay selection. Here you can decide now if you want to see the global measurements and local measurements or not. So here you can see you can switch off the global measurements, or you can switch them on and even change the position. So you can decide if you want to have the measurements on the left side or on the right side. Here in this measurement we have also local measurements, as you can see here. And here now we can decide to switch them off and also switch off the global measurements and also change the position of the measurements. For the 3D review in ImageCom, the lines of intersection mode has changed. So here you see they're completely fixed to 90 degrees and you can just move them against each other. And now we have a new button, that's the 90 degree or the free mode button. And now you see you can completely move the lines of intersection freely against each other and they're not fixed anymore. ImageCom now also offers an easier clip boundaries management. You can select if you want to play the clip just from R to R, or just the systole, or even just diastole. The worksheet now offers a GUI scaling, so you can make your worksheet bigger or even smaller as needed, quite easy, by just adjusting the buttons here. And then you can export all the measurements into a text file and save it directly on your computer. Or you can even save the measurements as a PDF. The auto tools work as before. The change in AutoLV is that we have removed the measurement for GLS in two-plane. In AutoStrain, we have removed also all the volume measurements, so the end-diastolic volume, the end-systolic volume, the stroke volume and ejection fraction. But we have also added some new measurements. That means we have added the length of the ventricle in systole and diastole for the two-chamber view and the four-chamber view. In 2DCPA, the workflow has changed a bit. So after loading the image now, the software forces you to check the timing. So instead of going to the M mode and select the timing step, you now really have to do it. So the first thing before you can draw the contour is that you have to check the timing. So the end diastolic and the end systolic frame, and select your heartbeats and so on. Another change in 2D CPA is that the analysis for the right ventricle is now performed in 6 segments. So after drawing the contour, you can go now to the segmental analysis, and you see you have 3 segments for the free wall and also 3 segments for the septum. In 4D cardio view, we also added the free mode for the lines of intersection. Here you can see the lines of intersections are connected, so you can move them in 90 degrees to each other. And then we have in the left corner the button for the free mode. After pressing the button, you can now freely move all the lines of intersection and create your own views. In 4D LV analysis, the workflow has changed. So now we have a direct start in the analysis state. So you start the software and it automatically jumps to the analysis, as you can see here. Of course, it is possible to go always back to the view adjustment, where you see now the GUI describes you the steps you have to perform. And then we have the timing definition, where you could add the timing. And then we have the LV tracking revision, where you can see the tracking of the full heart cycle. Here, of course, you could perform adjustments of the contour. And then the last step is the analysis. And here you see the analysis as you're used to it, but we added another measurement, the length of the ventricle. Please find all further changes in our next slide. Thank you for listening.